Hallo everyone, Styx is here once again, and this time with Kingdom Hearts Dark Road for now instance. Normally on Friday I talk about a new medal, a new banner in Kingdom Hearts Union Cross, but today they decided, you know what, let's just do for Kingdom Hearts Dark Road two new cards, and that's really about it. Just two new cards and nothing else. So yeah, it's kind of weird because it was already determined what the next medal will be, and I was hoping I can talk about that with that deal. Only that will come around on a different date by the looks of it. Kind of stupid because I'm used that it comes also. I'm just used it always comes on a Friday, but here we are. We have two new medals. Two new cards, and that's Axel and Kairi from Kingdom Hearts 1 and Axel from Kingdom Hearts 2, I assume. What's the special about those cards? Well, Kairi is a gauge boost and Axel is a dark green magic card. And the maximum power of the Axel is, if you have 10 copies of it, is 65 power. A powerful fire element physical attack. Oh, it's a physical attack. Oh, my mistake. I assume it was a magical attack, but it is a physical attack. As for Kairi, fills the bonus gauge stacking card. Fills the bonus gauge. Stacking card does not increase the value. So, what's so special about that medal? It's the first of its kind in the game. You can easily go to this, for instance, world battle, and autopilot is autopilot. You can see on the back when I fight or when Xehanort fights, a little gauge is filling up on the back, that yellow bar all the way on the back. Well, if that's all the way full, you get a 2x multiplier whatever happens. And Kairi is one of the first medals that allows you to use it at least a little bit sooner. Is that worth to go for the jewels from it? Well, no, of course not, because remember people, this is still the start of the Kingdom Hearts Dark Road. It was already announced at the end of this month, I think it was the end of this month, we get episode 2 of the story, where most people are here for, not for the extra content, not for the story, because let's face it, we are not going to play all of those events or even get the free card, the Mickey Mouse one. Because it's just too difficult for us at the moment. The only way you can beat the giant red watermelon, the huge watermelon, is if you do have a good card deck that is not easy to get with the daily pulls. Because if you do the daily pulls, oh, it's there. I'm just used to go on there on the menu button. For the daily pulls you get always shitty medals, but at least if you have 10 copies of one shitty medal, it becomes a good medal. Or card. I am used to saying medals on it. This one is the best one that we have. I can do it once more, but I'm not going to, because now I want to save up as much as I can. At least I have 100 tickets of them. And when I have 100 tickets of them, then I think it's the best moment to pull. Then you have 100 cards, and with those 100 cards, maybe you get a lot of duplicates. And who knows, maybe you get a 10 variation of a card, so it is increased in power. As for the jewels, don't do it, you get the bad ones, but sometimes a good one. And that for 3000 jewels? No, I don't see that. I just see this game still as a weekly free jewel. Weekly, monthly. Oh, I'm way behind with my weekly jewels. I need to do something in the weekend. Putting this on AFK. Just to get one key at 200 jewels and most importantly that free ticket. As for the beginner quest, where are the fat bandits, if I may ask? Oh well, but that's all what I have to say, to be honest. Is there still more value to go for the pool or the tickets? Well, definitely not. Just two new cards in there. If you want to collect them all, you can do it. It's your own money. There's nothing against it. I just don't go for it. I'll just wait for the next Kingdom Hearts Union Cross banner to drop out, so we can talk about that. Either way, people, I wish you all have a wonderful, wonderful day. Until next time. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.